workbook Plants the Food Producers. So worksheet 1, match the leaves correctly to their names. So 4 leaves they are given, right? And names also they are given. You are going to match the leaf to their
petal, P-E-T-A-L, sepal, S-E-P-A-L, receptacle, R-E-C-E-P-T-A-C-L-E.
Fourth one is gulmohar leaf. Okay, children? Yes. Section B. Unscramble and fill the correct answer. First one, food prepared by the plant is dash. So they are unscrambled and they are given the answer. Children, you have to find the right one. Glucose is the answer. G-L-U-C-O-S-E. Glucose. G-L-U-C-O-S-E. Glucose. Food prepared by the plant is called glucose. Okay? Yes. Second one. Dash is used for the growth of the plant. Answer is starch. S-T-A-R-C-H. Starch. Third one. Dash in the leaves traps the sunlight. Answer is chlorophyll. C-H-L-O-R-O-P-H-Y-L-L. Chlorophyll. Chlorophyll in the leaves traps the sunlight. Fourth one. Dash is an example of non-green plant. Answer is mould. M-O-U-L-D. Mould. Section C. Circle the odd ones given below. First one, crotons, parrot, cactus, coleus. So parrot is the odd one because all others are plants. Second one, sunlight, carbon dioxide, oxygen, moonlight. So moonlight is the odd one. Third one, mushrooms, petiole, midrib, veins. So which is the odd one here? Mushroom, right? Yes. Fourth one, stomata, chlorophyll, cow, photosynthesis. So cow is the odd one. Now section D. Label the parts of a leaf. So a leaf is given, you are going to label its
parts.
Now the parts are stalk, leaf base, side veins, lamina, midrib, apex. Stalk, leaf base, side veins, lamina, midrib, apex. Now worksheet 2, section B. Answer in one word. First question, what is the name for the edge of the leaf? What is the name for the edge of the leaf? Answer is leaf margin. Edge of the leaf is called leaf margin. Answer is leaf margin. Second one, which gives out a network of thin veins? Which gives out a network of thin veins? Answer is midrib. Answer is midrib. Third one, what is the term given for the plants that do not contain chlorophyll? What is the term given for the plants that do not contain chlorophyll? Answer is heterotrophs. Heterotrophs. Fourth one, what is the term given for the plants that grow in deserts? What is the term given for the plants that grow in deserts? Xerophytes. Xerophytes. Now section C. Identify the process and fill the boxes. Yes, a picture is given here, right? What is the process, children? Photosynthesis. So photosynthesis means plants prepare their own food, right? Yes, so the process is photosynthesis. Yes, and you can fill the boxes. Sunlight, carbon dioxide, oxygen, chlorophyll, soil, water. And in the process box, you have to fill photosynthesis. Now worksheet 3. Section A, how do saprophytes grow? How do saprophytes grow? Saprophytes grow by plants grow by feeding on dead and decaying matter. Section B, highlight the importance of afforestation and reforestation. Afforestation, to control pollution and to prevent soil erosion. To control pollution and to prevent soil erosion. Reforestation, to maintain biodiversity and helps in reduction of carbon dioxide. To maintain biodiversity and helps in reduction of carbon dioxide. So, reforestation to maintain biodiversity and helps in reduction of carbon dioxide. Now, section C, identify the tree and color it. What tree it is, children? Apple tree. Yes. Now, lesson number 2 in your workbook, adaptation in plants. Section A, match the plants to their types. Yes. So, first picture it is non-green plant. So, you have to match with non-green. Second picture it is parasitic plant. Third picture it is aquatic plant. Fourth one terrestrial. And fifth one insectivorous. Now, section B. Circle and write the right answer. First one. Trees which grow in the plains have dash stem. Option is thick or thin. So, the answer is thick. Trees which grow in the plains have thick stem. Second one. The conifers that do not shed their leaves are called dash forest. Options are deciduous, evergreen. Answer will be evergreen forest. The conifers that do not shed their leaves are called evergreen forest. Third one, children. Forests have a warm climate with dash rainfall throughout the year. Options are heavy, moderate. Answer is heavy. So, forests have a warm climate with heavy rainfall throughout the year. Fourth one, children. Mangroves have dash roots. Options, breathing log. So, answer is breathing. So, mangroves have breathing roots. Section C, identify the type of forest. Yes, from the picture given, you have to find the type of forest. It is mangrove forest. Answer is mangrove forest. Now, worksheet 2, section B. Match the picture correctly to their names. So, four pictures are given, right? So, first one is rubber. You can see it is rubber tree, right? Second one is pepper, okay? Third one is coconut. Yes, coconut tree. Fourth one is cardamom. Yes, fourth one is cardamom. Okay, fine. Now C, section C, answer in one word. First question, how are regions in the sea coast called? How are regions in the sea coast called? Coastal areas. Answer is coastal areas. Which plant's roots are fixed to the bottom of the pond? Fixed plant. Which plant's roots are fixed to the bottom of the pond? Fixed plants. Third one. Name the plants that cause harm on the plants they grow. Parasitic plants. Name the plants that cause harm on the plants they grow. Parasitic plants. Plants. Which are nitrogen deficient plants? Insectivorous plants. Which are nitrogen deficient plants? Insectivorous plants. Now worksheet 3, section A, know about mangroves. First question, which place in Tamil Nadu is famous for mangrove forest? Answer is Pichavaram. Which place in Tamil Nadu is famous for mangrove forest? Answer is Pichavaram. What is the speciality of mangrove forest? Breathing roots. What is the speciality of mangrove forest? Breathing roots. Yes, it has, the mangrove trees has breathing roots. Yes. Third one. Where is the world's largest single block of tidal aliphatic mangrove forest located? Where is the world's largest single block of tidal aliphatic mangrove forest located? Sundarbans in West Bengal. It is located in Sundarbans in West Bengal. It is the world's largest single block of tidal aliphatic mangrove forest. Sundarbans in West Bengal. How do you think mangroves protect soil erosion? By binding the soil with their tangled roots. By binding the soil with their tangled roots. Section B. Highlight the importance of neem trees. Used as medicine. Used for preparing cosmetics. Used as mosquito repellent. So, highlight the importance of neem tree. Used as medicine. Used for preparing cosmetics. Used as mosquito repellent. Section C. Identify the types of trees and color the picture. Yes. This is nothing but coniferous trees. Yes. So, answer is coniferous trees. Now, we will revise workbook lesson number 14. Pollution around us. Worksheet 1, section A. Match the pictures correctly. Yes. Some pictures are being given. Right, children? Yes. Acid rain, greenhouse effect, destruction of ozone, global warming. So, you have to match these pictures with the given words. The first picture is global warming. Second one, it is destruction of ozone. On the right side, first picture, it is acid rain. And the second one is greenhouse effect. Yes. Now, section B, circle the right answer. First one, air pollution affects the two options are given, digestive system, respiratory system. Air pollution affects the respiratory system. So, you have to circle respiratory system. Second one, drinking polluted water can cause jaundice or cancer. Drinking polluted water can cause jaundice. Third one, any unwanted noise or unpleasant sound leads to night blindness, noise pollution. Which is the answer, children? Noise pollution. Any unwanted noise or unpleasant sound leads to noise pollution. Fourth one, smoke from factories dash air contaminates or cleans. Contaminates is the answer. So, smoke from factories contaminates air. Section C. Identify the pollution in the picture. So, what is the pollution which is given in the picture? Land pollution. So, answer is land pollution. Worksheet 2, section B. Answer in one word. First question, which affects the growth of the plants? Answer is light, water, temperature. Which affects the growth of the plants? Light, water, temperature. Second one, expand CNG and LPG. So, expansion of CNG is compressed natural gas. Compressed natural gas. LPG is liquefied petroleum gas. Liquefied petroleum gas. So, the answer will be compressed natural gas, liquefied petroleum gas. Third question, which could cause health hazard when not disposed properly? Answer is chemical and poisonous substances. So, you have to throw it properly. You have to dispose chemical and poisonous substance properly. So, which could cause health hazard when not disposed properly? Chemical and poisonous substances. Fourth question, when do we celebrate the World Environment Day? Answer is 5th June. When do we celebrate the World Environment Day? 5th June. Now section C, identify the process shown in the picture. Yes, so first picture it is compost. So what is the process of compost? Is nothing but adding organic waste to the soil, like vegetable peels, all these things we will add to the soil, which will give nutrients to the soil. Then what is the second picture, children? It is vermicompost. Vermicompost is nothing but adding the worms or any other small species to the soil. It will add nutrients to the soil. Okay, fine. Now worksheet 3, section A, identify the device and type of pollution to be prevented. So a picture is given. What it is, children? It is nothing but headphone, right? So headphone. Okay, so what type of pollution can be prevented? Noise pollution can be prevented if you are using this headphone. So the answer will be headphone and noise pollution. Now section B, identify the bins used for biodegradable and non-biodegradable waste. Yes, the first bin you can see, it is biodegradable waste. It is in green color, right? Yes, so the waste which can be recycled are biodegradable waste. Second picture you can see, it is in blue color, right? So this is non-biodegradable waste. So the waste which cannot be recycled, we will put in non-biodegradable waste. Okay, yes. Now section C, suggest your ideas to protect our environment. Yes, so suggest your ideas to protect our environment. So first one, keep our surroundings clean. Second one, avoid using plastics. Third one, encourage afforestation. Fourth one, avoid deforestation. So first thing is, we have to keep our surrounding clean. So keep our surroundings clean. Avoid using plastics. So second one is avoid using plastics. Third one is encourage afforestation. So encourage afforestation. So planting trees we have to encourage. Avoid deforestation. So cutting down trees, we have to avoid cutting down trees. So avoid deforestation. Yes, children. So in today's class, we revised our CRP portions, right? Yes. Thank you.